in my flow.
What is up, guys? It is 6 in the morning, bright and early. Just stopped by Lottie Da, picked up a bagel, some bacon for breakfast, and we are headed over to Moulin Newport Beach right now. So a lot of people ask me where and what Moulin is. So Moulin's a bakery in Newport Beach. It's really good. I'm gonna get some breakfast there as well. But for right now, I just got a bagel. I'm headed over. All my friends are waiting for me. And yeah, guys, it's gonna be an amazing day. I can't wait.
Okay guys, we are here. My cameraman ran off. I have no clue where he is. This car show is actually really cool so far. We have the KOENIGSEGG JESKO, KOENIGSEGG Agera RS. There's two of those. Pagani Huayra Roadster. I mean, just look at this lineup for yourself. We're here with the all-new KOENIGSEGG JESKO. So this car actually has 1,600 horsepower. It's gonna be the first car to 300 miles per hour. The fastest car in the world right now is that record-breaking Agera RS right there. That car hit 277.98 miles per hour on a road test. That's actually insane, guys. So the car is actually named after Christian von KOENIGSEGG's dad, JESKO KOENIGSEGG, von KOENIGSEGG. So I think that's really cool to name a car after your dad. I wouldn't name my car Fred though. That's a little weird. So it's actually a V8 twin turbo engine that's pushing out 1,280 horsepower on regular fuel and then 1,600 on ethanol 85% gas. So you look at most normal cars, I mean, I don't think you're gonna find any other car except for some off-roading vehicles, maybe a Jeep that has harnesses. That makes you think why. It's either really dangerous or it's so stupid fast, like, you can't even stay in your seat.
One thing I really like about the car is that it's gonna come in two configurations. Top speed version and a track version.
And that's really impressive because a lot of people don't care about top speed and a lot of people don't care about how it performs on a track. They either want one or the other. For the track version, let's just say it's going to go like 280 miles per hour. They're still fastest car in the world.
Yeah, but if you want to do a top speed run, yeah, well, do it.
Look at the spoiler on this car, guys. Dude, that's some good clickbait right there.
Sure.
Dude, that is huge.
Wait, what?
It is absolutely the span of that thing's actually 6 feet tall. Okay guys, we are here with the 1975 Mirage. So this is actually probably my favorite car here. So I talked to the owner about it. It weighs 1,950 pounds and it's pushing out over 850 horsepower. You can hear the backfire in the background. Just take a look at this thing. This thing is actually just so clean in here. I love how the seats are kind of molded into the bodywork itself. And you look at the engine head and the cylinders. I mean, look at it for yourself. I can't even talk about it, dude. This is speechless. Like, I mean, look at this thing. When you take the time and effort to hand build a car yourself,
it was a track car that he bought.
A track car that, but he was saying he actually built most of it himself.
He probably had to rebuild most of it.
Probably, yeah. I mean, when you take the time and effort to do that, they give you a personal connection to these things.
It is quite cool.
That is. That thing's insane. Would I buy one? Absolutely. What do I rate
stick.
It? 12
can you
out of
drive
10.
It?
I can drive stick. Actually, I can. Yeah.
All right. All right.
Let's do it. I want to go for a ride. Guys, we're here with Gunther Works 993. So this is actually an air-cooled Porsche that's about 2,500 pounds, pushing over 450 horsepower. So whole entire body, chassis, and everything's all carbon fiber. They remade every single part of this car. This is honestly the most beautiful looking Porsche I've seen in a long time.
You speak up.
You can see the Brembo brakes are a special blue color. I don't even know how to describe it. Like a crimson blue, something like that. That's what it looks like. And inside the car is basically rebuilt to look like the new 911, and it's gorgeous. Here, let's take a look inside. I mean, you guys can really see the attention to detail on this car. Look at the door handles, look at everything. Even the new gear shifters, the new 911 one. I mean, every single part of this car is just unique. You're never gonna find a car like this. According to the speedometer, there's only about 89 miles on the car, which is really impressive. Oh my god, guys, this place is so French. Like, I walked in and I'm like, bonjour, and it was so nice. I don't know, this place is so unique. Oh my god, guys, look at the desserts in this place. May I remind you, it's 8 in the morning, but dessert before
orange juice is amazing.
Of course, I got my chocolates from London. It's the only good chocolate here. Oh my god, guys, there's so more candy here. Look at all of this. I'm not buying any more, though. My Kinder Bueno is good enough for me. I'm happy. Like, just look at the layout of this whole entire place, guys. How many desserts are we getting?
I'm getting none.
Well, as a vlogger, I think it's only right if I try everything, so.
That fruit tart, the seasonal fruit thing looks really good, actually.
All right, so this is probably my favorite car in existence, the Pagani Huayra. Not necessarily because of the stats that it boasts, but actually because of the design and the beauty inside and outside. It's not really driving a car, it's more like flying an airplane. Down to the very last detail, especially if you go inside the vehicle, you could see a bunch of the exposed gearbox set right there for the gear shift. You can see all of the dials are just like they would be in a cockpit, even down to the leather straps that hold, you know, the insides of the car together. It's such a beautiful car, and as you can see inside, it's 66 of 100. There's only so many out there. So it's not only a plane, but it's your personal plane, the one that you could fly out of John Wayne. So I'm a big fan of the Pagani Huayra, and if I had to own a car, it would be this one right here.
What's up? My name is Alex Rodriguez. Real quick, I just want to talk about one of my favorite cars, the Lamborghini Urus. I mean, such a beaut within itself. The color, the rims, 23-inch rims, it's insane. Like, they're so big. Like, I feel like it's just such a dynamic car, you know? Like, the design and everything, it's like so sleek with that little Lamborghini crest. The shape of it, it's not liked by a lot of people. I personally like it a lot. It's a Lamborghini, but it's also one of those cars you can drive your friends around. Like, that's that for me. That's why I like it. There's just so much, like, I just admire this car a lot.
All right, what's up? I'm Ryan. I'll tell you a little bit about the C63S AMG. It's my dream car, personally. It's gonna be my first dream car. All right, so looking at the front headlights, it has the same manufacturer headlights as about the S560. It's amazing. It has smart headlights where it'll move as you turn. So if you're going around a bend, the headlights will also move with it, so that you'll be able to see. Moving on to the brakes over here. These amazing, amazing steel brakes. Mercedes is known for their stopping power. Even though it is a little bit of a heavy performance car, it's great on the track. Also, if you take a look on the back of the spoiler, it has some aerodynamic tones to it, as well as the amazing sounding Mercedes AMG exhaust. It also has a hand-built V8 made by Mercedes. And basically, what you do when you order an AMG, one guy works on it and just works on the gears and puts it together for you, and then it's delivered, and it also has a signed insignia by the person who built it. It's an amazing dream car.
Favorite parts about Moulin is when all the cars leave. It's a lot of fun, and it's really funny because there will be people in normal cars, like, all these Jettas and stuff like that, and they'll floor it by, and it's just
like
I don't even know what he said. He just yelled something. I don't think the microphone's gonna pick that up. But no, it's a lot of fun. And you get to see some really cool cars leave, like the Koenigsegg. Let's see this G-Wagon here. That wasn't a competition sport. Okay, so an M5 competition sport pulled up earlier, and it was so cool. You just hear all the burbles and backfires, like, buh, 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 buh. That's like one of my favorite spooling sounding cars ever. I don't even know where. I think that guy probably left already, but I mean, like, look at this. You can hear the turbos. When your turbos are more expensive than your whole car. And it's like everyone with a Supra. Spent like $60,000 just upgrading that car. It's insane.
This is a cool little car. That's pretty low.
What is that? What is that noise? Oh my god. Okay, that is honestly the coolest car here.
Okay guys, we just finished with Moulin Newport Beach Car Show. Okay, how do you guys rate that show and the food? Pagani Huayra, best car in the world, my favorite vehicle, and I got to see it in person. I'm so hyped. That's awesome.
All right, so I saw my dream car. It was the C63 S AMG. It was a beautiful car. I give the car show an overall, I give it about an 8.5.
I give it a Doug score of like 8 out of 10 dubs, I think.
10 dubs.
Oh, okay. The food was amazing.
Oh, Moulin Cafe?
Yeah, oh my God. Prime. Literally, okay, the croissant was amazing. I bought my chocolates from London from there.
Get a panini.
Yeah, the panini was so good.
Really good.
Oh, I got two cappuccinos.
He got two cappuccinos.
It was fantastic. Yeah, yeah. Cappuccinos and then a panini, chicken pesto.
Okay.
Prime.
Dude, I had a, what's it called? I got fresh orange juice. That was so good. Oh, yeah. And then I got a croissant. I got
fruit tart.
Yeah, like a fruit tart.
That was good too.
That was my healthy breakfast.
Healthy option.
Yeah, breakfast for champs. A-Rod got some food. And then Masamori actually got a ham and cheese panini. I usually don't like ham, but that panini was so good, guys. So I 10 out of 10, definitely recommend you go to Moulin. It's an amazing car show. And the food's actually really amazing, guys.
Wow.
Yes. Okay. That's it for today's vlog, guys. I'll see you next time. What is up, guys? We are in the Speedmobile, aka the ILX. Oh my God! This is awesome. Guys, this is actually a really sick car. I'm digging this one. Matt drives it like a race car driver, as he should. Let's see that. The skills right here. The downshift.
So loud.
Dude, that is sick.
It rumbles.
That's actually
for
sick.
Like what, is this third gear right here?
Yeah.
Third gear.
Whip. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
What the heck?
It's like a racing course.
Jesus. This is actually awesome. I love this thing. Okay. Oh my God, I'm being thrown around.
You didn't expect it, did you?
Dude, not at all.
So. As you can see, we're not in the Tesla right now. We're actually in Ryan Kotov's
Ford Focus SE.
SE. Yes. And Dylan is driving because Dylan wants to try it out. So we're going to see what happens.
Dude, this car's fun. It just holds.
No, you're not doing handbrake turns.
No.
You will flat spot his tires.
Yeah. Oh, wait, I'm in the wrong lane.
How are you feeling right now about Dylan driving your car?
I'm feeling pretty good. He hasn't done anything stupid yet.
Erratic. Nothing.
Yeah, what do you mean? Yeah, I promised you I wouldn't.
Yeah, he promised. We'll see.
See, I love it. It's fun. It's a perfect car.
What do you like about it?
Everything. It drives well. I mean, to have a front wheel drive, like, it handles really well. I wouldn't get a front wheel drive car, but if I were to get someone like this, this is a perfect size front wheel drive car. It just works perfectly. That's what it does. That's what it needs to do, and it's perfect. I love it.
You love it?
I love it. I love it.
Hey guys, today I have a really special video. So I've been saving up for a long time now, and it's finally the day. Today I'll be doing a $2,000 donation giveaway. So all you have to do to enter is just subscribe to the channel, and once we reach 1,000 subscribers, I'll be giving away $2,000 to a charity of one lucky person's choice. So it's really simple, guys. Just make sure to subscribe. So go share the video with your friends and help make this go viral. I'm really excited, and whoever wins, let's just say they don't know what charity to donate to, I'd be more than happy to donate to our family school in India. Yeah, let me know if you have any questions. DM me if you have any special charities in choice, and yeah, good luck, guys. Let's do 1,000.